January, the busiest month for divorces. Teddy Ann coming up.
Sexton, we heard you.
Now you have another way to hear the best news talk programming anywhere in America.
At 960 KZIM, 1400 AM KSIM, and now
on FM
at 1017.
Are you ready for real reality? I'm talking about the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Are you really ready for it?
What are you talking about?
Anything. God, guns, crime, politics, you name it.
Nothing's off limits with Vaughn Riggins.
It's Real Talk with Riggins.
If you need to share your opinions, you should just call Talk Radio.
And talk to the Logic Queen. It's Real Talk with Riggins.
Will you guys talk or something?
It all starts right now.
Welcome back, Real Talk with Riggin. Thanks for being here on the Friday edition.
Everybody wants you.
Well, apparently not everybody wants you. January is the busiest time for divorce attorneys, so apparently they want somebody else. We're headed to the Anthony Service Company, Ream Heating and AC Pro Partner phone line, where family attorney and writer Teddy Ann Berry is standing by. Hi, Teddy Ann.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing okay. What is it with January where people just decide they hate each other?
You know what? People come off the year and just look for really big changes in January, and quite often they're looking to blame the other person in their life. You know, a lot of it comes from the stress of the holidays. Other time it's just financial wherewithal, and otherwise it's just people wanting something different.
Yeah, but why January? Because I think I got divorced in March. I think it was in March.
So that's the spring fever divorce. I've identified essentially four seasons of divorce. So we have the Happy New Year divorce, the spring fever divorce, the kids back to school divorce, and then let's get it done before the end of the year for taxes divorce.
Oh.
Which happens like late September, early October.
Yeah, you know, people get divorced for whatever reason. Some is abuse, some is drug abuse, some is just I don't love you anymore, some is I found someone else who's hotter than you. You know, there every reason is probably just a little bit different, isn't it?
It is. It really is a really personal and emotional decision for everyone.
You know, if you're not fighting over anything though, property, if it's an amicable, somewhat divorce, it can be a pretty easy process, can't it?
It can. It really can. You know, our website is this can be done in 92 days. And each state has basically a cooling off period from when you file for divorce to when the state will grant the divorce. So here in Colorado, it's 91 days. So our goal is to really try and keep people on that track and get through it and realize that, you know, this comes down to words and numbers. Most mm-hmm. states are no-fault states. No one's getting blamed. So it really is just a legal process, really.
Right. And as soon as the judge signs, you're done. I know some people who have been trying to get divorces for 7 years and they just can't afford it.
Wow.
Yeah. So is it really expensive or what's the deal?
It only becomes expensive if parties are going to be really litigious, right? It gets expensive if someone's going to come in and evaluate the parenting relationship and what the parenting schedule should look like. If we have businesses to value, if there are, you know, different taxes that we need to restructure, then it can get very, very expensive. And that's really why I try and advise people, make sure you know what kind of lawyer you're hiring.
Yeah.
People think that they want the bulldog attorney, but sometimes they don't realize the cost that goes with that unnecessarily.
You know, the lawyer who I went to because I've known him since high school. He's since passed away, rest his soul. But go to someone you trust if you know somebody, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Picking your lawyer is a real personal decision.
And let's face it, I know, Teddy, you've done this for how long? Teddy Ann?
21 years now.
My goodness. So you've seen a lot of emotionally distressed people, haven't you?
I really have, yes.
Yeah, and that's sad, especially when kids are involved, and oftentimes it destroys the kids for later in life, and that's when the blame game comes in, I think.
I think the blame game starts from before the divorce, if we're honest, right? Yeah. Someone's always looking to blame someone. I bet there's less than a third of my clientele that come in and like, this is all my fault, but I still have to get divorced, right?
Yeah, yeah. Well, no, it was all my ex's fault, but he still knew it, so it is what it
right.
is. He's still mad at me, though.
Yeah.
It's been 16 years, so you should get over it. Or no, 24 years. You know, if people want to get away from their spouse, you have to remember about the finances, though. Oftentimes, that is the reason. Isn't it sad that money is the reason?
It really is sad. I've had at least two couples in the last 3 years come to me and say, for insurance reasons, to qualify for Medicaid or whatever they needed, they couldn't be married and have both incomes. So
right.
they had every intention of staying together, but weren't going to legally on paper be together, which just broke my heart.
Yeah. You know what? I've heard of grandparents doing that. I really have.
Yeah.
That's so sad.
Well, and you
so
see,
sad.
Like, the gray, they call it the gray divorce. It's, you know, older couples, you know, I have so many more couples coming in, 20, 25, 30-year marriages now getting divorced and basically don't want to be liable or responsible for the other person financially for the next, you know, 10, 15, 20 years that they have.
Mm-hmm. That's so sad. But they stay together. They just aren't married anymore.
Some do.
Yeah.
Some don't.
You know, and sometimes there are sneaky spouses out there, and most people think automatically somebody cheated. That's not necessarily
right.
the case, even though kind of often is. But they could have run up like a $50,000 to $100,000 credit card bill, and you don't know about it. You go to get divorced, and that other one files bankruptcy, and they all come after you because you were married when they
right.
did it. That's a nightmare.
Right. That's really, it is a nightmare, and it's language that we have to explain in our separation agreement, saying the other part is indemnifying you, saying that they're responsible for the debt, but at the end of the day, the debtors don't care.
Uh-huh.
If they can't come after that person, you are still legally liable, and there's nothing in this divorce that changes your relationship with that creditor you had during the marriage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you know
and
what?
There are cases that we say that, you know what, if you're that close to bankruptcy, go handle that process together first before you get divorced, because if you try to do it in the middle of a divorce, they'll stay the divorce because that's a federal court versus a state court.
Oh, my goodness. Didn't know that.
I know.
Yeah.
That's happened at least two or three times in my cases.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. And I had to file bankruptcy when I divorced my ex because of that exact reason. That's why I know about it. And I was like, what's all this credit stuff? These phone calls. I was shocked. And obviously not a very close relationship, but when you start to run into divorce, I don't know how you do it all the time, Teddy Ann. Honestly, I'd be exhausted. But you got to think about the other people affected and be very careful, especially when kids are involved, right?
Absolutely. And just to go back to the debt thing, now that gambling's legal in so many places, we're seeing so much more that the other spouse just doesn't even know about.
Jeez Louise. All right. Well, I think divorce is relatively easy in most states. A friend of mine is separated in Virginia. They have to wait a year. State law.
Wow.
Can you imagine
being
stuck, having to, for me, when you take that vow, you have to keep it. So you'd have an entire year of being in limbo. A year is a long stinking time.
So here's how I counsel people through that. There's the legal technicality of you can't get that special magical piece of paper that says you're divorced, but you certainly can work through your assets and your debts and get that contract signed that the court can later sign.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, the contract law part of it, like, here's your agreement, go ahead and move on and wait for the legal decree.
Right.
But what happens too often is lawyers play to the timeline involved, and then they don't even necessarily start working the case, if you will, until they're up closer to the deadlines. And that's not the attorney that you want. You want someone who's going to handle it. You know, my tagline for my book, I wrote a do-it-yourself guide to divorce, is get in, get out, get over it, right? Like, you need to move on.
Right, right. And so let's talk about your book and where it's available.
Sure. Yeah, no, it's on Amazon. I have the Kindle edition right now. Hard copy's coming probably later this week. I did a second edition, if you will. It's specific to Colorado law, but there are so many, like, talk tactics and special language that I would, you know, advise everyone to at least look at and consider. It really is a good guide on what's going to happen to me now.
Yeah.
You know?
And try not to be a maniac.
How do I negotiate this?
Try not to be a jerk. You know, and
right.
A friend of mine whose husband just passed away, God rest his soul, it's been such a nightmare, but they were marriage counselors together, and you can bring yourselves back from the brink. It should be your last resort, not, oh, okay, it's my eighth marriage. I don't like this one either. Let's get divorced. You know what I mean? Some people don't take it serious enough.
Absolutely. And I tell my clients that all the time when I do that initial call. You can tell the people who are finding out about divorce but aren't ready for it. So I have a whole list of counselors, depending on their situation or where in Colorado they are, that I refer them to. I'm like, and I tell them that exactly. Like, my door should be the very last door you walk in, not the first. And I just had a former client call me the other day on a parenting issue. He's like, you know, Teddy Ann, I've been working with the same counselor since before I got divorced. I can't thank you enough for putting me in touch. So,
nice.
You know, the mental health of this and understanding emotional and the accountability and what's your fault and what's not, but how to do it differently or be better. Be a better person as you go through with this and come out of it, you know?
Yeah, it would be nice. So what in the name of our Lord and Savior made you want to be a family attorney? I can't even imagine it.
I started out in the public defender's office while I was in law school in Omaha, Nebraska, at Creighton. And I got in the juvenile section. And you could see all these juvenile delinquents, or a great part of them, it all flashed back to family issues.
Mm-hmm.
So then I came out of law school and I got into dependency and neglect work, which is where the state gets involved and takes the children out of the home. So I represented the best interests of the kids. And then at other times I represented the parents in those situations. And then from there, it was just a natural flow that I had this kind of experience to bring and perspective, really.
Mm-hmm.
To bring to family law and mediation.
And I bet mediation
just never look back. It just,
yeah,
it's great.
Yeah, I'm proud of you.
It's a great part of our practice.
I don't even really know you, and I'm proud of you, because this is this is a big problem in the United States. I know Colorado included, but I mean, everybody I know, well, not everybody I know, because there are a few lucky couples who make it past 16 years, but everybody I know has considered divorce, if not done it already.
Well, you know what? It just seems so much less socially taboo anymore.
Right.
Right? This generation, my generation had, you know, a ton of divorced parents, but now those coming up, a lot are not even wanting to get married.
Right.
So yeah. I just think the social dynamics of our culture have changed so much.
Yeah. Neither one of my kids ever want to get married. So, you know. That tells you a little bit about what they saw. But if people want to get Teddy Ann's book, you can get it pretty much where...
on Amazon.
Yeah, yep. Awesome. Books are sold. And I like the Kindle. I like to turn pages, but I also like the Kindle. Is there a car copy where I can, or a MP3 that we can get yet?
I don't have the audio out, no.
Yeah, you need to get that, because that's my favorite kind of book, because I like to drive and listen.
Right.
Because talk radio is kind of my jam. So if you're talking and in your voice and doing the book, that's my jam.
Sure.
That's how I read all my books lately.
Good to know.
Yeah. So Teddy Ann Berry is a family attorney in Colorado. She's also a writer. Make sure you get her book. Give them the title again.
The Do-It-Yourself Guide to Divorce in Colorado.
There you go. If you're in Colorado, do it there, but it'll help in any situation in any state. The laws might just be a little bit different. Teddy Ann, thank you so much for your time today.